Ever pondered about the existence of a marvelous, technologically advanced city lost beneath the waves? A city known as Atlantis. This legendary lost city, first mentioned by the ancient philosopher Plato, has intrigued and mystified us for centuries. Plato painted a vivid image of Atlantis, portraying it as a utopian society of immense power and wealth, its citizens living in harmony and prosperity. However, this idyllic city met a tragic end, swallowed by the ocean in a single day and night of catastrophe. Plato's accounts are the only historical record of Atlantis, a tale so captivating that it has seeped into our collective consciousness, sparking countless expeditions and theories. Atlantis, a symbol of man's ambition, his triumphs, and his downfall. So was Atlantis real, or was it just a myth? To answer that, we journey back to the origins of this captivating story. Our tale begins in ancient Greece with the philosopher Plato. It was in his dialogues Timaeus and Critias that the world first heard of Atlantis, a powerful and advanced civilization that supposedly existed 9,000 years before his own time. According to Plato, Atlantis was larger than Asia and Libya combined and was located beyond the Pillars of Hercules, what we now call the Straits of Gibraltar. Plato painted a vivid picture of Atlantis, describing it as an island paradise replete with mountains, fertile plains, and a highly organized, technologically advanced society. The Atlanteans, as Plato told it, were a noble and powerful people with a naval power that was unrivaled. But here's where the story takes a twist. Many historians and archaeologists interpret Plato's account as allegory rather than historical fact. His detailed, almost utopian description of Atlantis and its eventual downfall is seen by some as a cautionary tale about the dangers of pride and corruption. Others view it as a philosophical thought experiment, a way for Plato to explore his ideas about ideal societies and the nature of mankind. And yet, Atlantis isn't just confined to Plato's dialogues. Other ancient sources have referenced lost civilizations that bear striking resemblances to Atlantis. From the ancient Sanskrit texts of India describing a submerged city, to the indigenous legends of pre-Columbian America speaking of a sunken island, echoes of Atlantis can be heard. So we're left with a conundrum. Was Atlantis real or merely a figment of Plato's philosophical imagination? If it was real, where could it have possibly existed? And if it was just an allegory, why does it resonate so much with other ancient cultures? These questions have puzzled scholars, historians, and explorers for centuries, leading to numerous theories and explorations. But if Atlantis was a mere allegory, why does the search for its physical remains persist? In the modern era, the hunt for Atlantis has taken many forms. Some explorers have scoured the depths of the Mediterranean, guided by Plato's ancient texts. Others have ventured to the Caribbean, drawn by tantalizing underwater formations that bear a striking resemblance to the philosopher's descriptions. And then there are those who have dared to journey to the icy wilderness of Antarctica, captivated by theories that Atlantis lies beneath its frozen surface. These intrepid adventurers have employed everything from deep-sea submersibles to satellite imaging, from archaeological dives to meticulous analysis of ancient scripts, in their quest to find the lost city. Each expedition, each research project, brings us a step closer to, or perhaps further from, the truth. Whether fact or fiction, the story of Atlantis continues to captivate us, a testament to our enduring fascination with the unknown.